Hey, what's good, y'all? It's your boy, E. Sheila with Seismic Media. I'm coming to y'all today with something totally different. I normally do color grading tutorials, but today I kind of want to show y'all a little process that I do that I think I improve my cinematography and music video creation ability doing. It's called Music Video Fan Study. What I do is I watch music videos created by industry-leading artists or cinematographers, directors, whatever you want to call them. And what I do is I try to imagine how I would recreate that shot and try to achieve that look. Or if I can't achieve that look, I try to at least figure out what the cinematographer did to try to create that look, and just more so break down the different parts and the elements of that music video look to try to achieve that in my own work. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. All right, today we're gonna be looking at Chris Brown, Young Thug, City Girls. Actually never seen this music video before, so this is gonna be my first time actually watching it. I'm not really gonna do a review, but it's gonna be more so just like a breakdown. I'm gonna scroll through just like some of the more dynamic shots and just kind of give my take on how I think the cinematographer lit and blocked and arranged the scene, or how I would do it if I tried to recreate that scene. So jumping into it, I'm gonna play like the intro sequence, which is, I mean, it looks pretty much naturally lit. They shot it on a jib. So they brought the jib down from up high. It's probably like, I can't even guess what length that is. 16, 20 foot jib. And then they brought it down. And of course they had the focus puller follow the car, pull the focus while the car pulled up. Chris Brown hops out the car. Let's back up right here where I think everything here is natural, but I'm thinking like right here, right off of camera, has to be some type of large light lighting up Chris Brown right here that really wouldn't be natural. You can see how it's hitting his face right up in here where it looks like he's, you know, artificially lit. So I'd imagine he probably got something like, maybe if I was doing it, I'd probably do like a Aperture 300D with two V powered batteries. I probably wouldn't bring a generator for just this quick shot right here. Definitely a soft box, because it's not like a hard light. It's definitely a soft light right up in here. You can tell it's not really casting any shadows or no blemishes or anything like that on his face. So go forward here. Hops out the car. Walking the red carpet, fresh. It's a different crowd. All right, right here, I'm gonna have to say that all of this is just coming from the practical stuff in the feeling right here. Like, it's not artificially lit right up in here. Like, you can see some soft light hitting his shoulders, but it's definitely top lit. I don't think that there's anything extra into the scene that the cinematographer would have had to account for or try to bring on his own. I think it's just really the location. I mean, you get a fire location, you ain't got to really worry about too much. All right, I'll pause it here. As you can see, you got the practical spotlights in the back shining down, creating these beams of light right up in here. You can tell that they definitely use like a good bit of fog and haze for to get those shafts of light for to shine down, create that atmosphere. Whatever this is, or maybe these spotlights are hitting the people right here on the back, just kind of creating that edge light right back up in here. Let me draw it for you. Like, edge light hitting them here, hitting them here. The backlight on her, lit right up in here. So yeah, I'd imagine it's coming from these practical beams that's shooting down right up in here. If I was trying to recreate that, I mean, first off, it'd be securing like a fire location like this. You know, on some of the budgets that I'm working with, I may not be able to do that, you know. But just say if I got the location, I'd probably have to fit like an Aperture 300D with the, like with the Fresnel attachment. Like, if I can afford four of them for the shoot that day, I maybe bring two right up in here, two right up in here. shot him down in this X pattern, and hopefully kick maybe this one up to where you can maybe catch these, and then these over here is going to catch these lights right up in here on these shoulders. And as far as Chris Brown, we probably have something like up here shining down, because you can see we still got like a little hard edge on him right here on his face and a little hard edge right here on his shoulder. So I'd imagine they probably got something like above the camera, like probably on the balcony if it wraps all the way around, just kind of shining down. But I ain't gonna spend too much on this part right here. Just move forward. Let's see what we got. These beautiful shots. The flow pan. Yeah, it's definitely those lights that's creating those hard edges on these people. Chris Brown come around. He got the hard edge on him. Then he walks up to this bad chick. And it's like, what's up, Lamar? Alright, right here, I'd imagine, right here, camera left, probably a soft light, some diffusion right in front of it, shining, giving her this little glow right up in here, and him right in here, and you can see it kind of kicking off his head. It's probably not as diffused on him, but it's the same light source, I'm thinking, that's lighting up him in the back. And then there's going to be another light right up in here. And it's not behind Chris Brown. It's going to be more, it's closer to the camera, because it's giving her a nice little soft bounce, and it's giving him this soft bounce right up in here. So her and him, you can see that there's a light probably close to the camera on Chris Brown's backside. That's giving that. All right. Let's move forward a little bit. Let's see what we got. All right. I'd imagine the same lighting setup, just a different angle. And you can see just due to when you change the angle, like how it's hitting Chris Brown, how before it was more so on his side, now it's more so behind him. So it's giving more of a hot light right here on the side of his face, but still same soft light here. And more harsh on her face right here. Probably from this same light that's acting as a kicker on him and now on her. And this soft light here acting as her backlight, but it's acting as his key light. But it's a much softer light on this side. And you can tell how it's kind of giving this little triangle right here that is like right above his nose. But yeah, it's a fire shot though. So let's move forward. Oh, I'm going to be talking to this chick forever. We got that. Oh, what if this? This blue lens flare. Huh, I imagine it's probably, it's either a lens flare from one of the lights that's on that balcony that's shining down, one of those hot light spotlights, or it's fake. It's probably like fake lens flare just to add some little interest to the scene. Skip forward. Chris Brown right up in here. And let me do a close up right here. That's a fire shot right here. Definitely got a light off camera. I drew that too close to it. What's the point? But yeah. Okay. Definitely a light off camera right here with some diffusion. Giving it soft glow on his face right here. And we got another light. Like all of these lights right here are in like 3200 Kelvin, maybe 4000 Kelvin. It's more close to a tungsten light. But like you can see some blue right in here. Let me erase it so you can see it. But like some blue right up in here where there's some daylight panel that's kind of kicking off his face right up in here for the give that. But overall, it's a beautiful scene though. Skip forward a little bit. Okay. We got Shorty on stage. I think this go really without telling, the spotlight shining down. Pretty much giving her all glow, no shadows, hitting her from every angle. Probably got some more spotlights behind the camera, like above this same area right here, just shining on her frontal. But like it's real hot up in here. So you can tell they're not diffusing that. This is just spotlights. So let's move forward. And I'm going to play it a little bit. See what we got. Okay. A little performance scene for her. All right, let's skip forward. Don't want to get copyright flagged. All right, Chris Brown sitting at the table. Pretty much still the same exact lighting setup. You know, diffusion here, soft light coming from above camera, hitting them directly from the side. Camera shooting into the shadow side. So, you know, we got that little backlight almost on them. It's like what they call it, a three-quarter backlight. And we're shooting into the shadow side. Whatever's hitting him, I'm imagining hitting her and her. So it's probably just one big light source. If I was doing it, I'd probably say like an aperture 300D, like shining right into some diffusion material right up in here. I really wouldn't worry about blocking it off because it's not like it's white walls or anything like that. It's all wood walls, so it's not really going to reflect a whole lot of light, even though, you know, it's catching some reflection here, but overall, it's not doing too much. And especially in the gray, you can just pull that wood down real quick. So we're going to move forward. Huh, I wonder if this entire music video is one location. Just one fire story in one location. All right, so we go back to the entrance door. And I'd imagine just one big light source shining directly at the entrance. I'm not even going to draw that, but same location with the back lighting. So they definitely lit from above, right from out here. But if they come in, that one big light that's right behind the camera shining, just kind of lighting them up. Young Thug walk in. Everybody looking at Young Thug like, bro, who is this dude? Man, I'm just trying to have a good time too, bro. Homie calling the police. He ain't feeling that at all. It's cool. Chris Brown like, I think I smell a little racism. But you know, it's all good, bro. We got money. So we walking in here. He fresh. I'm gonna pause it right here. Right here on Young Thug and whoever this dude is. Like, you can tell if a light coming from like right up in here. Diffused. Because it's not like a real hard light. It's a nice soft light that's just kind of hitting them as like a backlight right up in here. And right up in here. And it's kind of lighting up this side of the jacket, but the camera's shooting into the shadow. So we move forward with it. Cut to two different shots, so pretty much the same angle. It's cool. Right up in here, I'm pretty sure these are still the spotlights. Even though, you know, whenever they cut to a close-up, they probably bring in another light just to control it more. With like some... Yeah, I think it's diffused. So it's probably like some type of diffusing material right here with the light shining right down on her. So, getting crazy with my drawing. Right here, probably more of the same. Oh, okay. Can't get a Chris Brown music video without Chris Brown dancing. Hold on, let's cut back to it. There we go. All right, so Chris Brown's on a stage, and we can tell we got a big, strong spotlight shining down on him. But the spotlight is going to be behind Chris Brown, like in between the whatever background this is and Chris Brown. And then the camera shooting into would be his shadow. But there's another light, or maybe even some bounce material, just bouncing that light back into him so he's not completely blacked out in the shadow like a silhouette. But it's shining straight down. So we only have this area of the floor lit with a bunch of fog. So it's creating like not really shafts of light, but like one big glow. Down. If I was trying to recreate that, that's really exactly what I'd do. I'd probably do one big, like an aperture 300D or my Lowell DP light. I'd shine it right down. Some diffusion material, some, but it'll be slightly behind them, so it's more of a backlight. But no, you know, there's no diffusion material on this either. It's just much higher up and a little bit off camera, so it's creating this glare because it's not diffused. It's definitely blowing out the hat, blowing out the shirt, blowing out the top of the hat. So it's not diffused at all. There's just a big hard light shining through some fog. Let me play it. Let me get a little bit of this. Oh, kill it. Young Thug walking up. They still looking at him crazy. Chris Brown dancing some more with the City Girls. That's definitely CGI. That's not there. Wonder what it looked like. Yeah, it's just CGI. And they camera tracking it. So as the camera moved, the City Girls moving, they probably got the camera tracking Chris Brown with like his orientation. So as the camera moving, the City Girls was locked to him. All right, cut to the close up. All right, it was so quick. I want to get the close up of while he dancing, because I think that it's a different look. I think that they actually put some diffusion above that light, because it's not really hitting them as hard. It's not. I guess they don't have it. But yeah, like the highlights on his shoulder weren't as blown out in the close up, like right up in here. Yeah, they either brought the light down. This bright ass light, I don't know what that is, but it's hitting them right here, but definitely behind them. It's not diffused. I thought it would have been. I thought it was, but nah, it's still blowing out the highlights in his shirt right here and blowing out his hat, and they're bouncing something back in his face. That way, he's not completely blacked out, like I said before. But yeah, it's real dope. All right, shorty dancing some more. Skip ahead. All right, this shot right here, fire. You could tell he backlit right here, almost in the same way that he was during the dance scene. Like a light much higher and behind him shining down right here, creating this edge of light right here on his shoulder and on his head, with another light shining like off right. That way you still had a shadow right up in here, creating that depth. And you know, you can tell that it's diffused right up in here because it's real soft light. It ain't really making a hard shadow on his face, just a soft shadow. But you still got this edge around him here. And probably whatever is hitting him in the back is hitting him in the back and her in the back. So it's way back there. It's probably on this wall, shining down on them, creating these edge lights right up in here. Edge on his arm, edge on him. See, if I was doing that, I'd have to use more than one light. I don't have anything bright enough to do that. So I'd probably have one big light shining down on them. And the cinematographer may have even used more than one light too. I'm not sure. Then, but I have one light shining down on them, and then I'd have a different light shining on him, on Chris Brown, and this guy here that's touching him on his shoulder. Chris Brown looking like he's getting ready to knock him out. But yeah, I'd use two different lights for the backlight, and then I use a third light acting as his key light diffused that I'd be shooting through, so that it's giving this soft light with this soft shadow right up in here. And yeah, that's definitely what I'd do. All right, delete all this and play. Let's see what we got. Oh snap. Come in with the Tommy gun. He about to let it rip. Oh. Okay, pause here. Spotlights shining, acting as a backlight on Chris Brown. Got another light coming from the right that's acting as a real hard edge light to his side right here. And then a third light acting as his key light right here. Shining, getting this hand and getting this side of the face. So you got that shadow right here on this side of the face. But the kicker light is kind of bringing some of that back right up in here. And you can tell this kicker light is daylight balance, whereas in this key light is tungsten balance. And we got the camera set at daylight balance. You can tell because this was white. And, you know, this kind of got that orange tungsten glow to it. Yeah. All and pretty much the same lighting setup as before when Chris Brown and Young Thug walked in. Big tungsten balance, key light. Oh, hit play. Tungsten balance, key light, right camera, right, shining on him with some diffusion. And it's definitely a daylight kicker on him that I didn't see on Young Thug before. But it's balanced real low. But it's just kind of getting given like a little soft daylight kick right here on the side of his face. Probably just really pop him from the background. He probably was blending in too much to the background. So they just added that just to kind of make him stand out a little bit. Shawty just ran off stage like, oh, Chris Brown, I want to hide with you. Why they shooting the place up, even though they're shooting at Chris Brown? Oh, man. Look at these CG bullet holes. Let's see if we see him again. I think I went past him. Yeah, the CG blood with the CG bullet holes. It's all good. I don't really do a whole lot of the CG, so, you know, I can't critique it. But CG blood right up in here. Even though, you know, we still got a little blood splatter right here. A little blood splatter right here. If it ain't the cleanest CG job, but it's still fire. Especially if you're playing this real time and I didn't pause on it. Nobody had noticed that. But let me go back to the car. You know what? I missed it. I wanted to kind of break down that little car scene, but, you know, it's all good. So, who directed it? Directed by Jake. I can't even pronounce that last name. I'm not familiar with them. But I'll definitely be checking out his work in the future. This is a nice video. So, that's it, y'all. That's what I like to do when I watch music videos. I don't look at music videos just like, oh, man, it's a pretty dope video. And just, you know, kind of let it go and vibe to the music. I like to just kind of go into, you know, like, how did they shoot it? Like, what did they use to shoot? How would I recreate these shots? And I think that ultimately, when I kind of look at a music video from that perspective, and I kind of view the music video as almost like a learning experience for just trying to make myself better and my cinematography and just overall my vision better. And like what I'm seeing and how I'm breaking down my footage. And like, I think ultimately, like, it makes you a sharper filmmaker, a sharper cinematographer. So that's all I got for y'all today. Hey, if you like that, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. I'm going to be bringing these to y'all in the future too. So, you know, tell me what y'all think about it. If y'all don't mess with it, man, just let me know that y'all don't rock with it and I'll keep on going. You know, I'm just trying to find some other content to bring to y'all during this coronavirus time. You know, it's kind of tough right now. So hit the subscribe button, hit that like button, and tune in next time.